first, I apologize. I'm a little bit sick. And then I took a medicine, and now I'm lazy and slow. So let's try to get the end. So there is a lot of works in Italy, in the literature, trying to create and manipulate and change the environment of a system in such a way that you can protect or you can create a state with some desired property. And these methods we call reservoir engineering, stabilization, design. I look for this question, studying the Lindblad equation, and I want to know some things about the equation, things like the uniqueness of the stationary state of this equation, properties of this stationary state, and I will do that mapping this equation into a classical dynamical system. And I want to answer, what can I say about the stationary state? My system will have a generic numbers of degrees of freedom. These are bosonic degrees of freedom, and the dynamics will be governed by a quadratic Hamiltonian. We're governed by a quadratic Hamiltonian plus a linear term, and the interaction with the environment will be described by this Lindblad operator, which is a linear combination of the elements of this vector x. Also, here we have quadratic combinations of these elements and linear combinations of these elements. One important quantity here is the mean value vector. You can yes. Me dê motivo. So, an important quantity here is the mean value of this vector x. And here I will define the most important quantities of this work. I construct this matrix, which I call the coherence matrix, using the Lindblad operators. And then if I took the real part of this matrix here, I have the part responsible for the diffusion in my system. If I take the imaginary part of this matrix, I have the dissipation, and I put together with the Hamiltonian of the system, and I create this matrix gamma. Gamma and D are the most important quantities for this work. If I take the definition of the mean value vector, put it on the Lindblad equation, and take the derivative of time, I find an inhomogeneous linear ordinary differential equations with the matrix gamma I showed you before. And I want to find the fixed points of this equation. Poincaré told us that you can classify this. And we are here interested in one type of dynamics, which we call asymptotically stable dynamics, that any initial condition closer to the fixed point of this equation will go asymptotically to this fixed point. Here we have a spiral asymptotic node, and a spiral asymptotically stable spiral, and a asymptotically stable node. In one degrees of freedom, there are only these two possibilities, but we have more in more degrees of freedom. And the question is, if I give you a dynamical system, which conditions are necessary to asymptotically stable dynamics? I want to know the characteristics of this matrix A. This is similar to the matrix gamma I showed you before. This was answered in the PhD thesis of Lyapunov, and he said that the asymptotic stability is attained when all the eigenvalues of this matrix A has negative real part. And he gives another criteria for find asymptotic stability of a matrix, and this is known as the Lyapunov theorem, and says the matrix A is asymptotically stable, that is, this condition is satisfied, if and only if there exist P and Q satisfying this relation with A. This is the Lyapunov equation. Note that there is no information about Q and P. If you find two matrix positive definite satisfying this equation, then this is a necessary and sufficient conditions for the asymptotic stability of the matrix A. And he said more. For asymptotic stability A, asymptotic stable A, then you have a solution for the matrix P here, and this solution is unique and is given by this. Another important quantity to characterize my state is the covariance matrix, is the mean value of products of the elements of the x vector, positions and momentum. If I put this definition inside the Lindblad equation, then take the derivative, then I find the equation for the evolution of the covariance matrix. And it's given in terms of the gamma and the D matrix I showed you before. Now, some considerations about the stationary state of the Lindblad equation. The stationary state is the one that does not evolve in time, so I take this and put it equal to zero. This is an algebraic equation for the operator Rho. Then there is no time dependence here. Then the solution will not depend on any instant of time, neither on the initial instant of time. So this does not depend on the initial Rho. The kind of the dynamics I'm working with, the linear dynamics, this preserves Gaussianity, so every state will evolve into a steady state, including any initial state, Gaussian will evolve into this state. So this state must be a Gaussian. Gaussians are functions of the mean value vector and of the covariance matrix. We don't need no more information. So given these two quantities, everything is determined. And for asymptotically stable dynamics, the solution for V in the Lyapunov equation is unique by the Lyapunov theorem. So it's completely equivalent to find the stationary state of this equation. It's completely equivalent to work with the stationary points of the mean value vector and of the covariance matrix. So this is a dynamical system, and this is a Lyapunov equation associated to it. And now I have information about the matrices that appears in the Lyapunov equation. The physics of the problem gives me what I need to get to this equation. Some state properties are described by a generic kind of relation, which we call bona fide relations. And all of them has this specific form, the covariance matrix plus a Hermitian matrix. For example, if I want to know if a state is entangled or not, a separable Gaussian state, a Gaussian state is separable if and only if these relations holds the sum of the covariance matrix plus ij partial transposition. If this is greater than or equal to zero, then the state will be separable. There are other properties, and what is important here is that all of them has this structure. I will take this structure and put this structure inside the Lyapunov equations to the Lyapunov equation and see what happens. So this is the Lyapunov equations that comes from the Lindblad equation. This is a generic Lyapunov equation comes from the Lyapunov theorem. Sometimes we'll find here in this work this, and sometimes this. When I'm speaking about mathematical results, I will speak about this equation because they are more general than the ones for this. But we want to conclude things about this equation. Then the first results of the work. One is the consequence, a direct consequence of the Lyapunov theorem, is that I can conclude about the positivity of some matrices looking for the positivity of others. Now, if, for example, in this proposition one, if K is positive semi-definite, then P will also be. If I restrict to the set where this matrix A or the matrix gamma are self-adjoint, then this condition becomes necessary and sufficient. I know that P is positive definite if and only if K is positive semi-definite. So the generic bona fide relation, I will insert it inside the Lindblad equation. And then I have two corollaries of the previous propositions I show you. So this quantity, the covariance matrix plus the matrix that gives you the property of the state in the bona fide relation, this will be positive semi-definite if this matrix here that I give a name, it is auxiliary matrix here, is positive semi-definite. Now, if I am considering the case where gamma or A are self-adjoint or the gamma is symmetric, then I have necessary and sufficient conditions which says that this quantity will be positive semi-definite if and only if this auxiliary matrix here is positive semi-definite. So what I'm doing here is I have a property of a state, of the steady state of the Lindblad equation, and this is directly associated only to the variables of the environment. Key and A are the matrices that comes from the Lindblad equation. Here are some examples. I say that a state is classical if and only if this relation holds. The matrix which gives me the property of classicality in this relation is minus the identity. Then I construct the auxiliary matrices using this, and I can conclude that if this auxiliary matrix here is positive semi-definite, then the state will be classical. And if gamma is symmetric, then I have a necessary and sufficient condition for classicality. This classical state comes directly from, we can create a classical state with this covariance matrix using a Lindblad equation with these two matrix representing the environment. Also the same thing for the separable states. The only thing that changes here is the auxiliary matrix, and you can use this for any bona fide relation. Another thing that you can see looking for the Lindblad equation is that if I take a general linear transformation, W, and if I transform gamma in D, my matrix is describing the environment in this way, and if these matrices are invariant under the action of W, then the covariance matrix of the system will be also invariant. What this means is that the steady state of the Lindblad equation retains the symmetries of the environment. So you can find the symmetries of your steady state analyzing all the symmetries of your matrices gamma and D. I'll give you only one example. For example, if my transformation is this one, identity, then gamma and D to be invariant has to be this form, this direct product sum. So your covariance matrix will have exactly this form, and this represents a product state, a state without correlations. And you have another other examples, but I don't have time to speak, I think. And now I will analyze the properties of the steady state of this system. These are two oscillators interacting via Hooke's law, and each one of the oscillators is attached to a thermal bath, where n bar is the mean occupation number of the thermal bath, and zeta is the coupling between the bath and the oscillator. Kappa is the coupling, the Hooke's constant. The Hamiltonian of this system, it's the Hamiltonian of two coupled oscillators. The Lindblad operators here are described by linear combinations of the creation and annihilation operators. Then I construct the matrix, the coherence matrix, construct D and gamma, and here I can see that gamma is not equal to gamma transpose. So all the results here will be only necessary conditions. Gamma to be asymptotically stable has to be all the eigenvalues with negative real part. Since zeta is the coupling between the bath and the oscillator, it's positive, So this dynamics is asymptotically stable. Now I will use my corollaries to get results on this system. So I construct the auxiliary matrix, and the to this auxiliary matrix to be positive, its eigenvalue has to be positive real part. And then, all the eigenvalues of D are positive, it must be positive. So if I work out the eigenvalues of D, I find that the state is separable if and only if the ratio between the coupling with the BAF and the Hooke's coupling, if this is greater or equal than this function written in terms only of the occupation numbers of the BAFs, the state will be separable. The state will be classical. I do the same thing for another auxiliary matrix. And then the state will be classical if and only if the same ratio as before is greater or equal than this other function. I will plot these two functions. And what I have here are two surfaces in as a function of N1 and N2. And I can say that, since this is only a necessary condition, I can say that states which lies on the blue surface or above the blue surface are separable. I cannot say nothing about the states under the blue surface. And for the green surface, the same thing, but for classicality. States on the green surface are classical. States on the green surface or above the green surface are classical. I cannot say nothing about the states under the green surface. Another example is an optical parametric oscillator. This is the Hamiltonian of this system. And I will consider also two thermal baths as before. And now I construct D and gamma. And here gamma is a symmetric matrix. Then all my results will be necessary and sufficient conditions. So analyzing the eigenvalues of all the auxiliary matrix, I can say that I state the steady state of this system will be classical if and only if this relation holds. This is a parameter. These are two parameters of the Hamiltonian, epsilon and kappa. And I can say also that the state will be entangled if these relations holds. And the state will be steerable, another quantity, another property of a quantum state, if and only if these relations holds. So I provide here a connection between a classical and a quantum formalism. I have a useful analytical criteria working only on the environment variables. This works for a generic numbers of degrees of freedom. This can be used for reservoir engineering, where we can use the environment in favor of some quantum property. And this can be this is extensible for any kind of bona fide relation. For example, one that I didn't mention here, tripartite entanglement. This work is a collaboration with Mauro Paternostro and Alessandro Ferraro, two very nice guys. And thank you for your attention.
So are there questions?